Some are only slightly larger than the Sun despite having hundreds of times the Sun's mass. Despite having a mass over a million times greater than that of the Sun, the black hole at the heart of our galaxy is just slightly larger than our solar system. Due to their tremendous mass, black holes are condensed into a very small area of space, which allows them to be both extremely massive and relatively small. Some black holes, though, are quite enormous. What is the universe's largest black hole? Do you want to take a guess? The Phoenix A is the largest black hole ever discovered. Hello guys, and welcome back to Salty Space. In today's video, we will see more about the Phoenix A, which is said to be the biggest black hole ever. Watch until the end, and don't forget to like and subscribe to our channel for more such space content. Hit the bell icon to never miss any updates from us. Thank you. Now, let's jump right into the video. So, before we look into the Phoenix A, do you know what a black hole is? The event horizon of a black hole is an area of space-time where gravity is so intense that nothing, not even light or other electromagnetic waves, have the energy to cross it. According to the theory of general relativity, a compact enough mass can bend space-time into a black hole. The event horizon is a line beyond that in which there is no escape. Despite having a significant impact on the outcome and circumstances of an object traversing it, general relativity states that it lacks any locally observable characteristics. A black hole behaves in many ways like a perfect black body since it does not reflect light. In addition, event horizons are predicted to emit Hawking radiation, which has the same spectrum as a black body and a temperature that is inversely proportional to mass according to quantum field theory in curved spacetime. Black holes are not simply holes or empty places, despite what their name might imply. Black holes are dense mass accumulations that prevent even light from escaping them. Anything that crosses the black hole's event horizon, also known as the point of no return, is permanently lost due to the black hole's gravitational attraction. In space, these are not unusual occurrences. They're thought to be between 10 million and 1 billion black holes within the Milky Way galaxy alone. Now let's know more about the Phoenix A. The black hole at the center of the Phoenix cluster, also known as Phoenix A, is well known for two things. First, with a stunning 100 billion solar masses, she is the most enormous black hole known to date. Second, she exhibits peculiar qualities. There are many things we don't know about her, but her biggest mystery is undoubtedly how she manages to have eyes that stand out so much from other black holes. It's possible that she is doing this to her own galaxy and many others. She has a history of doing this to other galaxies and using it to gain mass, which resulted in every galaxy not trusting her, but she is planning to find a way to win back their trust. She is known as quite possibly the cruelest black hole to exist, trying to pull a kind grin and gain everyone's trust before ultimately backstabbing and likely eating them. There are many factors causing her to grow, including the starburst processes occurring in her cluster and galaxy, the relativistic jets that she is producing to help form stars, and the black hole's increasing mass as a result of all of this. No one is sure what she will do when she becomes even more massive, but nobody believes it will be good. The enormous Phoenix cluster is an ABELL Type 1 galaxy cluster that may be found in the southern constellation of the same name. The South Pole Telescope team first discovered it in 2010 while conducting a 2,500 square degree survey of the southern sky utilizing the SUNYAEV-ZELDOVICH effect. It is the most brilliant X-ray cluster ever found, emitting more X-rays than any other known huge cluster, and one of the most massive galaxy clusters ever observed, with a mass on the order of 21,015 m. It is situated 8.57 billion light-years away from Earth, or the co-moving distance. The Phoenix cluster has undergone extensive study and is regarded as one of the most significant classes of objects of its kind because of its extraordinary features. According to multi-wavelength observational research by M. McDonald and colleagues, it exhibits what is known as a runaway cooling flow and has an extraordinarily high cooling flow rate. This is one of the highest measurements ever taken in a galaxy cluster's core. The very strong cooling flow, in contrast to other galaxy clusters, has been hypothesized to be the result of the Phoenix cluster's lack of feedback mechanism to prevent runaway cooling flow. In contrast to the Perseus and Virgo clusters, the heating mechanism anticipated to be produced by the central black hole was insufficient to create a feedback. This is further reinforced by the center galaxy Phoenix strong starburst activity, where stars are produced at a rate of 740 million per year. This indicates that the central active galactic nucleus was not producing enough energy to ionize the galaxy's gas and suppress starburst activity. Around 8.5 billion light-years away, in a galaxy cluster called the Phoenix Cluster, is the largest black hole yet found. One of the galaxy clusters in our universe that has received the most attention is the Phoenix Cluster. It may include up to 1,000 distinct galaxies, and the star creation rates in its galaxies are exceptionally high. The cluster's core galaxy, known as Phoenix A, may be the most fascinating one. Over 700 times more stars are forming in Phoenix A than in the Milky Way. One star forms on average each year in our galaxy. Every year, 740 stars form in the Phoenix Cluster. Phoenix A is currently going through a phase called a starburst phase, in which star formation is happening quickly. Phoenix A is one of the known galaxies with the highest levels of activity. Phoenix does not exist solely due to asteroid formation, an intriguing study subject. The galaxy's center contains a largest black hole ever discovered. This black hole, which is estimated to be a genuine behemoth in terms of mass and scale, is unlike anything we've ever seen in our galaxy or any of the other galaxies in our local region of space. According to estimates, the Sun's mass is equivalent to 100 billion times that of the black hole in its center. Even more enormous than certain galaxies is the supermassive black hole. The black hole's event horizon measures 366 billion miles in diameter, or nearly 100 times the distance between the Sun and Pluto. It would not have been possible for this black hole to develop from a star due to its enormous mass. Instead, the supermassive black hole Phoenix A must be one of the oldest black holes in the cosmos because it likely resulted from the collision of many supermassive black holes that were created soon after the Big Bang. Furthermore, the size and mass of the black hole itself are increasing. It is currently absorbing enormous amounts of matter, adding 60 suns to its mass annually. It is thought that the supermassive black hole in Phoenix A is a primordial black hole, which means that it probably among the first to develop following the Big Bang. The supermassive black holes' precise genesis is still unknown. However, it's likely that they were created before the first huge galaxies were formed. Astronomers think the supermassive black hole play a significant role in the development of galaxies since they're founded at the center of almost every giant galaxy. But this is a kind of chicken or the egg scenario. Did the formation of supermassive black holes precede that of galaxies, or did the formation of galaxies precede that of supermassive black holes? Which came first, the galaxy or the black hole? Two theories aim to provide an explanation of how supermassive black holes formed. However, this subject remains unresolved. First, it's possible that supermassive black holes originated from the gravitational collapse of gas and dust immediately following the Big Bang, either before or during the creation of the first stars. The universe possessed a tremendous amount of material that could create stars before they even began to form in great quantities. A supermassive black hole might have directly formed if enough material had gathered and imploded under its own gravity. The second theory states that smaller black holes merged to produce supermassive black holes. Both hypotheses may be correct, or they may be another one that hasn't been found yet, explaining how black holes like the one in Phoenix A has come to be. And so with that, we have come to the end of today's video. I hope this video was informative and interesting to you. Maybe it possibly sparked some interest in the mysteries that this universe holds. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe if you found this video interesting, and we'll be back with more space wonders and mysteries very soon. Stay tuned to watch them, and we'll see you in the next video.